She was born as a slave, and somewhere around 1834, when Sarah was 12 years old, she was sold to a man who owned a riverboat. And so he had a job of hauling material up to Fort Pierre in the Dakota Territory, and he put this girl to work, and her job was to be the cook. She must have been a very bright girl, because apparently she sat down one day with a lawyer who was on the riverboat traveling, and she told him her story. And he said, "The next time I'm down in Missouri, I will appeal to the court to see if we can get your freedom." He did that. Now that she was free, when she got to the little bitty town called Bismarck, she got off of the boat and moved into Bismarck and went to work making a living. There had been rumors for a long time circulating around the country that there was gold in the Black Hills. So when it was announced that the 7th Cavalry, which was under General Custer, was going to do a Black Hills expedition, and she went over to the general and said, "I would like to hire on as a cook or a seamstress or whatever it takes." And he hired her to go on this expedition to the Black Hills. She was the only woman. 1,100 men, soldiers and teamsters and gold seekers and other people, here she went along on the ride. She became friends of Horatio Ross, who was the man who discovered gold in the Black Hills in August of 1874. And she was one of the 10 people who filed a claim in what is now Custer, South Dakota. She was the first woman ever to have a gold claim in America. And that picture was taken in downtown Deadwood. And the reason for that was that after she discovered gold in Custer, South Dakota, she never really came back here, but she did come to the Northern Hills a year later when gold was discovered up in Deadwood Gulch. That's where she set up the rest of her life, and she bought a ranch. She would buy cattle, and she would sell the beef to the miners, and she was an entrepreneur. This lady was something. She was something else.